It's Sonny and Finn's Wrestling and Video Game Podcast. This week we talk about the latest gaming news, we talk to our friend and fellow YouTuber Gaming Mule about No Man's Sky, and we give our thoughts and predictions for SummerSlam and NXT TakeOver Brooklyn 2.
What's up, guys? Welcome to episode 26 of the Sonny and Finn Show. I'm Sonny, and I'm one of your hosts, joined, as always, by the one and only Finn Steele.
I am the one and only... I can't do those words. Hello.
Good intro.
Thank you.
How are you doing?
That's going to be my theme song from now on.
Is that what your theme song is going to be?
Yes, when I become a wrestler, that's going to be my
when you become a wrestler, that's that's confidence.
Yeah, when I'm in WWE, that's going to be, they're going to pay the extra money to get the licensed music.
Are you going to be in next year's Cruiserweight Classic?
Absolutely.
Because you're definitely, under the weight needed to be in the Cruiserweight Classic.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I'll be there. I'll fight Kota Ibushi. Why not?
Yeah, sure. How have you been? Have you been doing anything fun? I know you've been doing some videos of ours.
Yeah, making a lot of more versus videos. Played some SmackDown. Here Comes the Pain.
Yeah,
it's excellent.
It is, and the videos are great as well. You do a very good job of our videos.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You are far more talented than me. I'm just a voice and a face.
That's right. That's what we need. We need a Paul Heyman to our Brock Lesnar.
Wait, which one am I?
You'll be the Paul Heyman, I guess. The one who talks.
Oh.
And I'll be the one with all the talent.
So you're the one just doing suplexes?
Yeah, I'm the suplex machine.
And I'm the talentless one.
Wait, what? No, we're both talented in our each individual way.
Okay.
Yes.
I'm not insulted at all.
Good. You should have been. It was an insult.
Good start to the show.
Thanks.
Solid. We're going to be talking to our friend, the Gaming Mule,
mm-hmm.
A bit later on in the show. We had a little chat with him via Skype, and we talked to him about No Man's Sky and a few other bits, so that's good.
Mm-hmm.
I like having guests on the show.
Yeah, it's fun.
We need to get more guests on.
Yeah, I think so.
We'll get Steve back on to talk some wrestling.
That'd be good.
In the build-up to Backlash, we'll try and get him on.
Okay.
We'll drop him a text and we'll see what he says.
Cool.
But I like having the guests on. I like talking to people who are on the same wavelength as us.
Yeah, definitely.
Our follower count on Twitter's gone up a ton.
Yeah,
I
know.
You've been busy. Last day or so.
Yeah.
Which is good. It's excellent. Nice to interact with more people.
Definitely is, yeah.
One thing I hate about our Twitter, and it's not... I like using our Twitter. I like tweeting about the game and wrestling stuff. But it's when you follow somebody and they ping back an automated message that says, hey, thanks for the follow. Please check out our YouTube channel and blah, blah, blah. It's like, come on. We don't have that. And
no.
I would never dream of it because it's something that I just can't stand.
Same here. It's like, come on, man. You're not real. It's a robot.
Yeah,
it's with like, automated words.
We like that you're a real person who tweets, but you don't need an automated message.
No.
Like, we had some people follow us yesterday who I had followed, and they were like, thank you for... Like, they sent an actual personal tweet saying, thank you for the follow.
Yeah, that's right. I like that.
And then when I tweeted back, I got a response, so you know that they're, like, a real person.
Yeah. That's the way to do it.
Although, actually, saying that, we got an automated message through.
Mm-hmm.
I think it was an automated message. But he's like, oh, I followed your, subscribed to your YouTube channel and all this sort of stuff and blah, blah, blah.
I didn't know it's our subscribers club on YouTube. So.
And I went onto our YouTube and I was like, oh, okay, you actually have. So I messaged back because I noticed our subscriber count had gone up. And we had a nice little bit of chatter, actually.
Awesome.
So it's been good. It's been good interacting with new people this week.
Yeah, good.
It's something I'm a big fan of.
Yeah, that's something you can do, which I don't do much. Interact with people.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's what I'm like, the social buzzard.
Yeah, you're the social media manager of Sonny and Finn.
I will take that. And you are the video and audio content manager.
Thank you. I like it, yeah.
We've given ourselves executive roles.
We have,
in this two-man business. We run the show.
We do. We are the show.
We are the show.
We are the big show.
We are the Sonny and Finn Show. We are a weekly video game and wrestling podcast that posts each and every Friday across all podcast services and YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk video games.
Okay.
We'll save our No Man's Sky chatter for a little bit later on in the show when we talk to the Gaming Mule.
Yep. Sounds good to me.
We've both been playing it.
Yeah.
Have you been playing anything else?
Honestly, not really.
No?
Mostly just No Man's Sky, yeah. I'm hopelessly addicted at the minute.
Okay.
It's a lot of fun. How about you?
Yeah, I mean, I have been playing a lot of No Man's Sky. I don't know how many hours I've put in. I think maybe between 8 and 10, perhaps. I can't tell.
Yeah, it's hard to tell,
how many hours I'm putting into it.
There's no, like, count or anything.
No. I haven't really been playing much of anything else. I mean, I've restarted, Tomb Raider Definitive Edition.
Oh, yeah, nice.
Because I've got these games that I must have got for free, so sitting in my ready-to-install folder on Xbox One.
Yeah, I've got loads of those.
Like, yesterday I noticed Rayman Legends there, and I was like,
that's a good
game. Didn't know I had this on here.
Yeah.
So I downloaded it and started playing it, and I was like, God, I fucking love this.
Yeah, it's
so good. I forgot how good it was.
Yeah.
That is platform imperfection.
Absolutely.
Like, when I was playing, I was thinking, why didn't I reference this when we were talking about Sonic the other week?
Oh, yeah.
Because...
yeah, it's a lot of similar things on there, actually.
Because, like Rayman had a rough start, and it's had a rough middle.
Yeah.
But since they've took it and made it 2D and just made it a stunning looking platformer. I was going to call it art, and that's what it is.
It is pretty much art, yeah.
It's like oil painting backgrounds with phenomenal music and just excellent gameplay.
Yeah, it's great.
Like, they took... what they were trying to overcomplicate Rayman, I think.
Yeah, they had a couple of good games in there. But yeah, it was very hit and miss.
Yeah. But now, like, you see the name Rayman, you're like, well, this is going to be an absolute hit. It's going to be excellent.
Yeah, I love Rayman Legends. I think I 100%ed it on Xbox 360.
Yeah, it's superb. So I started that as well. I'm just like, I'm dipping into games. To be honest, I'm literally waiting for FIFA and Pro Evo to come out now.
Oh, yeah.
Because I'm just filling my time with whatever...
Yeah,
and that's basically how it is at the minute.
Fair play.
I'm so excited for FIFA and Pro Evo.
Cool. I'm not.
I know. but
I will play you at it though, and beat you at it.
I want to play both with you because I want your opinion as a gamer as to which you think is the better.
Okay.
I don't care as a sports fan because you're not. I want to know as an outsider. And as a gamer, which you think is technically the better game.
Okay, I'll do that.
So we'll, the demo for Pro Evo comes out next week.
Okay.
So after we've recorded the podcast, we will do a stream of it.
Okay.
And I want to know your thoughts on it.
Okay, yeah. Sounds good.
So we'll do that.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
Cool.
Look forward to that.
Yeah, that'd be good. Some gaming news. Gamescom is on at the minute.
Yeah, so it is.
It's not really that. Nothing really much happens at Gamescom.
A couple like minor announcements, but nothing huge.
Nothing. It's not E3.
No, it's not.
Titanfall 2.
Yay.
Has an open beta starting this weekend.
Awesome.
And it's on this weekend and next weekend, and there's going to be different things in both betas.
Cool.
It's on PS4 and Xbox One. It's open, so anybody can go in and download it and play it.
Sweet.
I'm excited.
Yeah, I'll play it.
I'm stoked for it. Like, yeah. Really, I am. I love the first one. Anyone who listens to this podcast will know that I love the first one.
Yeah, I like it too. It's good.
Yeah, I still have it on my Xbox One. I refuse to delete it.
It's too good to delete.
It is, but people are still playing it because it became free recently.
Oh, yeah, it did, didn't it? Yeah.
So,
awesome.
Keep fighting that good fight, pilots.
Yeah.
But I'm really looking forward to playing it. I'm going to play it this weekend.
Cool.
Are you going to play it on this weekend as well?
Yeah, sure.
Do you want it? Are you going to play it on PS4 or Xbox One?
Probably PS4.
Okay.
How about you?
I'm going to play it on Xbox One.
Okay, well, I'll play on Xbox One then, just play with you.
But that's because I have the first one on Xbox One.
Yeah, makes sense.
And I'm going to stay true to the Xbox One because I feel like Titanfall is that kind of experience.
Makes sense.
I think the controller is better suited to first-person shooters on Xbox One also.
Okay.
Right. You don't agree?
Yeah, they're about the same, really, to be honest.
I disagree. I think the sticks are better.
Yeah.
And the hand shape just feels better on Xbox One.
I agree that the 360 controller was better than the PS3 controller, but I like what they've done with the PS4 controller. I don't know. I can bet.
Oh, I like the PS4 controller. Don't get me wrong. I like the feel of the Xbox One controller.
Yeah, that's fair.
Okay.
But yeah, I'll play on Xbox One to play with you. That'd be fun.
Yeah.
Maybe we stream it. That'd be cool.
We could stream it, but that means we'd have to use Twitch. Oh, we have a Twitch channel. We do.
We should.
Which we never use.
Yeah.
We need to probably do more with that.
Yeah, I would think about streaming some WWF, Just Bring It. Go and unlock all the like wrestlers and stuff before we play it as a versus. So it might be cool to stream that. I think I found a website where you can stream to Twitch and YouTube at the same time.
Ooh.
So I might try using that just to see.
And what is this? What is this website that you found?
I don't remember.
Oh, okay.
It, I think it's in my bookmark somewhere. I'll find it later.
Okay, fair enough. Okay, so people have been receiving codes this week. I don't know if you have or even if you even registered for it.
Yeah,
what's for, that? For PlayStation Update 4.0.
Oh, yeah. I think I registered for it. I haven't got a code for it.
I think I registered for it also. I haven't got a code.
Well, screw you, PlayStation.
Motherfuckers. This is why I prefer the Xbox.
Yeah.
I'm joking, I love you. But I quite like some of the features that it brings to PlayStation.
Hmm.
Or at least what's in there so far before its official release, which I'm predicting is going to be around the same time the VR comes out.
Makes sense.
Yeah. So it's got some good stuff. It's got like quick menus.
Cool.
So now, you know when you hold the PlayStation button down and it brings up that bloody big menu that covers the whole screen?
Oh, yeah.
Well, it's no longer going to do that. It brings it up at the side of the screen. So, like the, you know, like when you press the Xbox button on the controller and it brings up the menu at the side?
Mm-hmm.
It's basically that.
Okay.
Which I like. Yeah. It's sleeker. It means you don't have to really leave gameplay and it's still sort of going on in the background, which I like.
Yeah, that's fine.
You can view trophies offline.
Okay.
I'm not sure why. Apparently you couldn't.
Yeah.
Apparently there's a way around it, but it's not like a thing you can do.
All right. Weird.
I'm not sure why people want to do this, though.
Yeah.
Whose PlayStation isn't online?
It's a good point.
Like, if you've got a PS4, surely you have it online.
Yeah,
plus,
so.
if you're excited for the firmware update and that you can view trophies offline...
How would you download it? It's a mystery.
As far as I'm aware, I mean, I have a Vita... And I can view trophies offline, I'm certain of it.
I mean, yeah, you can do it on PS3 as well.
So I'm not sure. That was a confusing one to me.
Yeah, a bit weird.
But you can... there's some other bits. You can edit your own personal profile.
Okay.
So you can have, like... so you know, like, when you go on your profile and you've got your little picture. Like, I've got Parappa the Rapper as my picture.
Cool.
You can, like, edit, like, a lot more of it. Like, the background. You can have, like, your own personal picture and stuff like that. So they're changing things. The what's new... you know the thing where you press down on what's new and it's like what everyone else has been up to? It looks a lot more user-friendly. So it's a lot nicer to look at. So it's set out in categories. And like, because it's bloody everywhere at the minute. It's like adverts in there and there's somebody got trophies for doing this and somebody's played GTA for the first time and all this. This is crazy.
Yeah.
So I'm looking forward to when it comes out officially. I'm disappointed I didn't get into the beta.
Yeah.
Come on, Sony.
Yeah, sort your stuff out, Sony. Come on, Sony.
Did you not hear us? We are the show.
Yeah, we are the show.
The show.
The we're number not, one show.
We're not a good show.
Yeah, we're not a bad show.
We are the show.
We are a mediocre show.
We are an average show. We're just two idiots talking into microphones every week.
Pretty much. That's most podcasts, though, I think.
Especially if you listen to last week's podcast when we were... It was the ramblings of madmen.
Pretty much.
It was just people... It was just talking.
Yeah.
It was nonsensical... Wittering from idiots.
Talking about our favourite rap man.
Yeah. See, I like rap music.
Yeah, cool.
Finn, I just enjoyed Finn's take on it.
Yeah. That was my take. With the PDDs and whatnot. P-daddies.
PDDs?
PDD. That's from Kirby.
So, there's a lot to look forward to on... Oh, and also, this is a cool one, actually. They're changing the time of video that you can upload to Twitter. So currently it's like 10 seconds.
Oh, yeah.
Which is...
Garbage, yeah.
But now it's 140 seconds.
That's much better. So I might use that, actually. I'll post a few things on there before.
Yeah, I like it.
Yeah.
I synced my Xbox to our Twitter yesterday, actually, awesome. So I can start sharing some screenshots and some videos and stuff.
Good stuff.
I've got a cool Hulk Hogan and Ultimate Warrior video from WWE 2K15 to share.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm going to do that later.
Awesome.
I'm going to get to that one in a minute, because I want your opinion on it.
Cool.
Here's one that... who cares, right? Call of Duty Zombies is back.
Yeah.
In Infinite Warfare. It's taken on an 80s theme.
Right.
It has David Hasselhoff. Of course.
I love it.
The epitome of the 80s.
Yeah.
They've got Baywatch in brackets here. Like,
maybe don't know
Baywatch
who he is.
Wasn't in the 80s. Baywatch was in the 90s.
Yes, that was.
Knight Rider would have been a more appropriate thing to put in brackets, perhaps.
That's a good point, yeah.
And Paul Rubens, who, of course, is, I think he's Pee Wee Herman.
Sure.
I'm going to have to Google that.
Yeah.
But either way, it's got Pee Wee Herman and Blow, which is a movie, in brackets here.
Right.
That's fine. So, to be honest, it looks quite cool. It looks pretty cartoony, but it's like an 80s sort of neon-themed It's called Zombies in Spaceland.
Right, okay.
These zombies things get more elaborate every year.
Yeah.
I've played the last couple. I don't really enjoy them, I have to be honest.
Yeah, same here. I enjoy watching other people play them on like YouTube or whatever, but
I think I don't like them. It is Pee-wee Herman, yeah.
All right, cool.
I don't like them because I'm crap at them.
Yeah, same.
This is quite simple, really, but...
Yeah. The only one I played was the one that, the first one at World at War. It was just kind of... Meh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good campaign, terrible multiplayer World at War.
Yeah.
I think everyone would really love another World at War.
Yeah, I think so. They acted like had good multiplayer and stuff.
If it had good multiplayer.
Yeah.
The maps were crap. The multiplayer itself was fine, but the maps were terrible.
All right. Weird.
Unless you like the maps.
I don't remember. Yeah, so long ago.
I just remember it being terrible.
Yeah, I remember not liking it.
I love the campaign.
Yeah.
Okay. This is garbage news that I'm about to report now.
Okay. I think I know what it is.
So Hideo Kojima left Konami last year.
He did.
In interesting and still really unknown circumstances.
Yeah, something.
It was a very strange situation.
Yeah. They fell out.
Metal Gear Solid was his baby.
It was.
It is also my baby. I love Metal Gear Solid.
It is all of our babies.
Yeah. When that PS1 game came out, that changed everything for me. That changed the way I looked at video games.
Cool.
Like, forever going forward.
Cool. I missed the first one. The second one was the first one I played. And then I jumped back later and played the first one.
Oh, okay. That's fine. Yeah. I thought you were honestly about to say I have never played the first one.
Oh, no. I've definitely played the first one. Don't worry.
I think I'd have killed you with my microphone.
I played the first one and I've got Twin Snakes on the GameCube, which I played through.
Ooh, what a stunning game.
So good. Expensive too.
So, Metal Gear Solid is fantastic. We all love Metal Gear Solid. Everybody loves Metal Gear Solid.
Mm-hmm.
So, Konami thinks that it's acceptable to now continue the franchise in Hideo Kojima's absence.
Mm.
And they are bringing out a 4-player stealth game set after Metal Gear Solid Ground Zeroes, which was the prologue to Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain.
Okay.
It was, wasn't it?
Yeah. I mean, I was thinking, you'd set between the two games?
What?
Like between Ground Zeroes and...
Oh, yeah. It says here, 4-player stealth game set after Ground Zeroes.
Weird.
So before The Phantom Pain.
Bizarre.
To be honest, I've watched the trailer for it. I don't know if you have.
Yes.
It's not acceptable to do this, I don't think.
Nope. it's basically a 4-player survival zombie game.
It is, yeah. That's exactly... Basically, it's like... it's going to be like a 14-hour episode of The Walking Dead.
Yeah.
With Metal Gear Solid tech... And no real relevance to Metal Gear Solid. It's no continuation of the story. It's going to have no effect on the Metal Gear Solid lore. It's a cash-in.
Yeah. I mean, zombie survival games are like this generation's Call of Duty clone from last generation. Like,
yes.
So many of the bloody things on Steam or on like indie games.
Yeah.
We're tired of it now. And now Konami just like jumped in and thought, oh, what's popular? Oh, zombie survival games. What franchises do we have we can turn into that? Oh, Metal Gear. Kojima's not here anymore. He won't mind. And so it just ruined it forever.
Well, it's not a case of he won't mind. He's got no choice.
Yeah, screw Kojima. Yeah.
I watched the trailer. It looks like Metal Gear Solid.
Yeah,
it looks like Metal Gear Solid 5.
Yeah, it's obviously using the same engine.
It's using the Fox engine. Mm. It looks gorgeous.
Yep.
And it does.
It does, yeah. Graphically, yeah.
But yeah, you see the trailer and it's like, okay, yeah, fine, whatever.
Yeah.
And then like at the end, it's like, have you got what it takes to survive? And then like it shows Metal Gear above it and it's like, okay, bring a game out called Survive. If you have to use the Fox engine, use the Fox engine, fine. But you don't have to tag Metal Gear on it.
Yeah.
People are going to fucking hate you for this, Konami.
They already do.
Yeah, they already do hate you.
Yeah.
And they're going to hate you more.
Ugh,
I have no issue with using the Fox engine. Pro Evo uses the Fox engine.
Yeah, oh, awesome.
And it's stunning for it.
Yeah.
So use it to death because it's great. Don't use the Metal Gear Solid franchise, don't use the Metal Gear franchise to peddle your crap games that nobody wants.
Yeah, it's funny because some Konami representative was on Reddit saying like, oh, don't worry, Konami's still making big console games. They want to like win over the fans again. It's like, and this is what they show us. Bloody 4-player
This isn't winning anybody over.
No. We've got the unicorn
zombies. If this is good, I will eat my words and apologise when it comes out in 2017.
It won't be.
I am not. I already hate this game. Yeah. I hate it because it's got Metal Gear tagged on it, and it's not a Metal Gear game.
Yeah, it has a lot of work to do to make people care about it, and I don't think they've got it in them anymore.
No, I don't.
Konami lost it a long time ago.
Yep. I mean, they have dedicated teams working on Pro Evo and stuff like that, which is fine, and they do whatever they do.
I feel like Pro Evo's got its own little corner in Konami's office wherever they just work on that.
But that must be the only other moneymaker for them.
pretty much, yeah.
Treat your franchises right.
Yes.
Quit fucking around. Otherwise, you're going to end up like Metal Gear, like Resident Evil.
Yeah.
Look at Umbrella Corps, a game that nobody wanted and nobody is playing.
Yeah, it was so bad. Resident Evil 7 better be good, bloody hell.
What's this?
Resident Evil 7 better be amazing.
It really had better be amazing. This is one that I've been waiting to talk to you all day about this.
Okay.
And because this is not something that I go hunting for, okay? These are games that are on my radar because they're big games.
Mm-hmm.
Final Fantasy 15 has been pushed back to the 29th of November. So 2 months and a little bit after it was initially supposed to release. I want to know what you think about this because this is your genre of game. This is your thing.
The first thing that went through my mind was that Darth Vader... No.
Yeah.
Because like, oh man, I was looking forward to that. Yeah, that sucks, man. I don't know. It's gonna be good, I think. I don't mind waiting 2 months. It's just we were so close. It was there. We're waiting 10 years for this game, and it's like we could taste it, and now you pushed it away from us. Just 2 months.
Yeah. I mean, do you think? Right. Because. Because when I heard the news, I did sort of have a look into it.
Mm.
It was supposed to come out in September. Persona 5 is coming out in September also, is it not?
In Japan, yes.
Or around the same time. Yeah. So, now Persona is a growing franchise.
Mm.
Do you think that the presence of Persona has Final Fantasy shook a little bit?
Possibly, yeah. It's definitely got a very big following behind it. I don't know if it's as big as Final Fantasy. At least not yet. I don't know, it could be. It could be something to that, I guess. But I don't know. I'm not sure if Square Enix would be scared of Persona.
Oh, no, and I don't think it should be. Yeah. But I think Persona is growing, and it's because it's still fresh, you know?
Yeah. I'm personally personally looking forward to Persona 5 more than Final Fantasy 15.
Okay.
There we go. Because Persona 4 was pretty much my favourite game ever.
Now, I played the demo for Final Fantasy 15,
mm-hmm.
and I enjoyed it, but I don't play those games.
Yeah.
That's not my thing.
That's fair.
But I enjoyed it, but people who do like that thing have said that it really hasn't demoed well.
I don't know. There's a certain, section of the fan base who wishes it was all still turn-based and old school, which is fine. You can think that if you want, but I'm all for change and mixing it up. Because if they were all the same game, you would get bored of it eventually.
Of course, the same with anything. Of course,
yeah, exactly. If they Call of Duty'd it, it would just get repetitive and dumb. But I really like the demo. I really like both demos they showed. I like how it looks. I don't know. I love it.
I was gonna get this game.
Yeah.
I have to be honest. Persona has piqued my interest a little bit because people talk of it and hold it in really high regard.
It's so good.
And I quite like the art direction of it as well. But I have to be honest, I fear a little bit for Final Fantasy 15. It's going to sell millions around the world.
And millions.
Yeah. It's going to sell millions around the world. So Square Enix have not got to worry about that.
No.
But I don't think at this point it's going to review well.
Ooh, I don't know. Yeah, it could go either way, really. It could be the next... I don't think it would be as bad as 13. I like 13. Nobody else liked 13. And didn't review that well. It reviewed okay. But yeah, people on the internet gave it all kinds of crap.
But I don't think this is going to review well. Just from sort of general consensus from what's been shown so far, people have not been overly impressed. An outsider like myself, I enjoyed it, but again, this isn't my thing.
Yeah.
I just fear for it a little bit.
Yeah, I think your fear is justified.
When was this announced?
Final Fantasy 15 originally as Final Fantasy versus 13 in like 10 years ago, so 2006, 2007.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. So if people aren't impressed with what they've seen so far, and this game is 10 years deep.
Mm-hmm. It went through a lot of changes in those 10 years.
We'll see. I mean, yeah. I want it to do well. I really like. I really like the demo that I played.
Mm. Same.
But it's come to my sort of thing now where, you know, it's free running and it's the combat is free flowing.
Yeah.
Where turn-based combat, it bores me to tears.
Fair enough.
Unless it's South Park, it bores me to tears.
Yeah.
They're not bad games, just not my sort of thing. That's
yeah.
all.
That's fair, yeah. Like FIFA.
Exactly. Yeah. It's exactly like that. It's like you with FIFA. You wouldn't sit down and do 125 hours on FIFA like me.
Exactly, yeah.
So it's just one of those things.
But yeah, Persona 5 has the ability to be amazing. Now, Persona 5 could be Persona's Final Fantasy 7, for example.
Okay.
And like to push it into that next level. So, yeah.
If you think that highly of it, then I trust that it is going to hit those sort of...
Yeah, I can only do Persona 4 high,
sort of high peaks.
Yeah, I think it will. If you want, I can lend you Persona 4 Golden on the Vita. You can play that, see what you think.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's fun.
WWE 2K17 week 3.
Yay.
It's looking better every week.
It is.
Okay, so we got that crappy Brock entrance the other week.
Yeah. Did you ever seen the new gameplay for it?
No, have you?
Yeah, it's really good.
What, video gameplay?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Need to go look it up.
Tell me about it.
It looks really good. I like it a lot. It looks a lot smoother. The frame rate's better. Animations look great.
On the wrestlers or everything?
Everything, pretty much. And sort of like a ladder match, and the Money in the Bank thing, but they've changed how it works. It's more like a little mini game. It looks fun. I don't know, man. It looks really good.
In what sense? What do you mean when you say mini game? Because obviously you literally pull at the thing and eventually
it comes off.
It randomly will just come off.
Yeah, so basically, just trying to explain it, there's a spinning circle in the middle and you're controlling like a little red ball, and you've got to get a red ball into the spinning circle when there's like a little gap. And they got to do that a few times. And once you fill the bar up, it comes off.
Okay.
It's hard to explain. They just see it, really.
Is there like different animation for this going into this minigame?
Kind of, yeah.
Okay.
There's just all tons of new animations. You can run up the ladder now, which looks cool.
Oh, okay.
So it's not just like a slow little slog. I imagine it would still be slow if you're out of stamina or whatever. But
I knew they were going to change the animations for the table matches and the ladder matches. That is long overdue because they've used the same animation and the way that it works technically probably since SmackDown 2.
Yeah, pretty much. I think they've changed it so you can't put a ladder up wherever you want. You can only put it in like a certain positions.
Okay.
Which is fine because as it stands right now, in 2K16, the ladders are like super glitchy. When you put it down, it glitches across the floor. And
stupid.
It flies miles away out of the way.
And it so can I'm be kind like of pushed like across the ground by people walking into it.
Exactly,
it's just
yeah.
not realistic at all.
Yeah. So I kind of like that. It also showed them like setting it up between the ring and the barricade. So you like suplex people onto that and stuff.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
So that's pretty cool. That's new.
Good.
It also showed off the backstage stuff. Backstage is back.
Yay. How does it look?
Really good.
Really good?
Really, really good. They showed between Cesaro and Seth Rollins and also Randy Orton, Brock Lesnar. At one point, Seth throws Cesaro into the next room along. They go into like this little split screen thing. So you like see what's going on between both rooms.
Okay.
That's very cool.
So it looks it sounds like it's going to be quite expansive backstage then.
Looks like it, yeah.
Okay, that's good. That excites me.
Yeah. They're showing like picking up like a random thing and then hitting Cesaro with it, like climbing up on boxes and stuff. So it's interactable environments and stuff.
Really I used to love backstage on SmackDown 2.
Yeah, same.
Because there was so many different backstage arenas and it was bloody huge. And bear in mind this is a PS1 game.
Yeah, yeah.
I used to love having like hardcore battle royals for the hardcore championship. It was so cool.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
This excites me. I'm very much looking forward to it now.
Yeah,
because there's different stuff coming out.
Yeah, I never got the excuse that the technology wasn't there to like do backstage areas. It's like you did this on PS1 for Christ's sake. How was the technology not there?
I know.
But yeah, it's coming back. It looks really good. Highly recommend checking out the gameplay for it.
The third batch of superstars have been announced.
Awesome.
Let's run them down. So, they're in alphabetical order. That's good.
Good.
AJ Styles.
Yay.
Alexa Bliss.
Good.
WWE Hall of Famer Alundra Blayze.
Good.
Arn Anderson. Bam Bam Bigelow, Becky Lynch.
Good.
The Bushwhackers.
All right.
Bo Dallas, Christian.
Good.
Curtis Axel, Dana Brooke.
Oh.
Dolph Ziggler.
Good.
The Dudley Boys.
Mm-hmm.
Who look excellent in the screenshots that I've seen.
Oh, good.
Emma.
Mm.
Eva Marie.
Mm.
Fandango.
Yeah.
Kofi Kingston.
All right.
Lita. Mr. Ooh. Perfect.
Yeah.
Naomi. Mm-hmm. Natalia. Neville. Randy Savage.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Ravishing Rick Rude.
Cool.
Rikishi.
Nice.
Shawn Michaels. Sting.
Mm-hmm.
Stardust.
Okay. Why?
Yeah. Summer Rae.
Okay.
Tamina. Tatsumi Fujinami, WWE Hall of Famer.
You know the one.
Trish Stratus, Tyler awesome. Breeze, and Xavier Woods.
That's cool.
So they're filling out the roster. They have said that it's going to be bigger than last year.
Impressive.
I mean, you know, I don't play as half of the people that are on last year's, but yeah. So I like the idea that it's going to be bigger.
Yeah, that's cool.
It'll be interesting to see who's going to be DLC.
Hmm.
I think maybe they need to think about it first and wait to see what's going on before they announce it.
Yeah.
Because before, when they announced it last year, it was horrifically out of date.
Yeah.
The Shining Stars,
the Matadors.
The Matadors were in the NXT or the Rising Stars pack, and they weren't even around at this point.
Yeah. Crazy.
So, that's pretty stupid, but I'm glad that we are now getting more substantial information and more promising information.
That's really good.
Now, what was interesting in the press release that they brought out last week regarding WWE 2K17 is how they mentioned the brand split.
Oh, yeah.
They actually mentioned it in there. So that's promising.
Mm.
Hopefully it'll be patched in if it's not already in the game, which I would like to hope it is.
Yeah.
But we know how these things work.
Yeah.
They've said that the universe mode is going to be better. No showcase mode.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. That's fine.
That's fine. And there's the career's going to be refined.
Good, because careers kind of sucks.
It sucks big time, yeah. So, good. Very promising stuff. We've got, 2 months until it's released?
Yeah, the fact that they're taking out 2K like, showcase means they're putting more attention into like the career and all that stuff.
Yeah.
Makes me very happy, because that needed attention.
Oh, 100%, for sure. Okay, so that's pretty much it for gaming news, I think.
I think so.
At this point, we'll drop in our conversation that we've had with Gaming Mule, and you can hear our thoughts right now on No Man's Sky with our friend Sam, aka Gaming Mule.
Yes.
Okay, guys, so we are talking with our good friend, the Gaming Mule.
Yes.
I know him as Sam Webb.
Ooh.
Everyone else knows him as the Gaming. That's fucking shit. We'll start with
a real name drop.
I was going to drop your real name. Are we okay to do that?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Maybe not my surname.
Well, what's your surname?
I don't know. Oh, go on. Yeah, you can use my real name. It's fine.
It's not like MI5 are going to come after you.
You never know. You never know.
I know.
I might end up getting loads of fans, and they may just end up, you know, standing outside my house throwing their knickers at my front door. You never know.
How many fucking Sam Webbs do you think they are in the world? Just type it in on Facebook. There's one. There he is. Nuneaton. Go there. Pants at the ready.
Anyway.
Okay. I'll leave your last name out just in case the pan-throwing army happens.
No, if you use my full name. It's fine. It's fine, really.
No, I'm not going to now. You don't deserve the pants to be thrown at you.
We'll give you a fake name.
Yeah, you don't deserve the pants.
Damn it.
This is what our podcast is like every week. I don't know if you listen to it or not. But this is just what it is. Just fucking stupid nonsense. Okay, guys. We are talking to Sam, a.k.a. the Gaming Mule. Sam, how are you, my friend?
I'm very well, thank you. How are you?
I'm very good, thank you very much.
Yes, good, thank you.
So,
good.
We're going to talk to you just about No Man's Sky and a few other gaming bits, but tell us a little bit about yourself first. Tell the Sonny and Finn listeners who you are and what you do.
Is this how I'm going to sell myself, is it?
Yeah, we want you to sell yourself. That's what you're here to do.
Okay, well, as Sonny's already said, I'm the Gaming Mule, and I've got a YouTube channel, and I basically do Let's Plays and reviews. I do quite a mix of things, to be honest with you.
Sure.
Yeah, I do movie reviews, I do Let's Plays, I do one of my more popular series is retro toy reviews. That's where I look at kind of toys from my childhood. I think the most recent one I did was some Power Rangers ones. That's me in a nutshell, really.
That's good. I mean, I've watched your videos. I like your videos. Obviously, we are friends in real life outside of the internet.
Well, that's what we tell people anyway.
We do tell people, yeah. Really, we're just internet friends. Yeah. Masquerading as real life friends.
That's right.
You know, we're not exactly setting the world on fire as far as YouTube goes between us all.
Yeah, we're trying.
But we've talked about this, and you know, we want someone else's opinion on this and how good it feels to get some feedback from, you know, people who watch your videos and then start following you and things like that, even though we're sort of, you know, really relatively new between all of us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, I think it's definitely good to kind of I don't know if I want to say work together, but certainly give each other some feedback, and you know, I think we help each other out a bit.
Yeah, I think we do.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, absolutely think we do. Sam, what are you playing at the minute?
Well, at the minute, as you've already said, I'm playing No Man's Sky. I'm also playing a lot of, which I've been doing since the start of my YouTube channel, and I still haven't finished it. I'm playing Papers, Please.
You're still playing that?
Which I'm still doing.
It's a good game.
I'm too good at that game. I just can't lose at it. I'm also playing Elite Dangerous, which is something I would quite like to talk about when we actually get onto No Man's Sky.
Sure, yeah.
And that's pretty much all I'm playing at the minute, really, to be honest. How about yourselves?
We've both been playing No Man's Sky, really.
Yeah, pretty much. Not No Man's Sky.
I've been dipping in and out of a few other bits, but nothing too substantial outside of No Man's Sky, really.
Mm. Yeah, same. Yeah. I was addicted.
Yeah. What have you got coming out soon? Have you got any videos on the way, or?
I've got some more Papers, Please on the way, obviously, you know.
Of course, yeah.
I've got some other retro toys with Mule coming up as well. Mm. I've got some more Power Rangers stuff. I've got some Star Wars Lego that I want to do as well. Another thing that I didn't actually mention before is I do Loot Crate unboxing videos. So I've got my monthly Loot Crate that should be arriving quite soon as well.
Cool.
So, yeah, that's what's on in the pipeline at the minute.
Excellent. Right, let's talk about No Man's Sky. So No Man's Sky released a week ago today.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, it came out last Wednesday, didn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, so we've all had it for a week. Mm-hmm. Sam, you go first. Tell us what you think of it.
I kind of have mixed feelings about it, if I'm going to be completely honest.
Yeah, same.
That's fair, yeah. Because
I am enjoying playing it, but it's certainly not, I don't think it's quite the game that was expected. It seems to be a very casual game, not kind of the hardcore grind, I suppose, as we were expecting. I mean, the game is a grind, but there seems to be no skill involved in the game or anything like that. It seems to me like some kind of weird mesh between Minecraft and Elite Dangerous. It kind of tries to do everything that those games do. Sorry, it tries to do everything that those games does, but doesn't do them quite as well, but sort of mashes them together, kind of like a Reader's Digest sort of thing.
Okay.
That's my first impressions of it. But it is enjoyable, and I am going to continue playing it, and I have put quite a lot of hours into it. But I'm still kind of on the fence. I think I need to put more hours into it until I really decide how I feel about it.
Okay.
That's fair.
Finn?
Yeah, I'm enjoying it. The main thing for me is I just find it relaxing. I like just walking around the planet, scanning stuff, just, I don't know, talk to aliens, learning the new language and all that stuff, and just, you know, flying around new places. And I like interacting with, like, Atlas stones. Like, there is a hint of story there. It's like, I want to find out more. It's like, what is out of the stone? What is this, like, weird, goopy stuff I keep finding?
Yeah.
Like, dead bodies and stuff. It's like, I want to know more, and I want to just, I don't know, continue my journey, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, I'm on the fence with it a bit. I mean, I know that's a bit of a cop-out, but It's just one of them games where I don't feel like I need to go back in and play it like instantly. Like I do an hour or so, but you know, I don't really feel like I have to focus on it. I can go to a planet, do a bit of scanning, pick some stuff up, and you know, realistically, the crux of the game is make sure you've got enough stuff to warp to the next part of the galaxy.
Pretty much, yeah.
And just carry on down the orange line to the centre of it. But I like it. I had reservations about it anyway. I didn't think it was going to be a mind-blowing experience.
Yeah, I think a lot of people had really high expectations, way too high than it could possibly deliver. I think that's what annoyed most people about it. Like, oh, I want this to be this multiplayer thing where you can meet up and trade with each other and like craft your own base and all this stuff.
Yeah, it's not that at all.
It's not that, no.
No.
No, I have to admit, I think I was somewhat part of that kind of hype train where my expectations maybe were a little higher than what was actually delivered in the game.
Yeah,
but they certainly weren't as high as some of the other people that I've seen online and things like that. You know, some of them had really high, really, really high expectations.
Yeah.
People sending death threats to developers and all that.
I can definitely see why the game would be ruined for them.
Yeah.
Yes. I think for someone like me who didn't have high hopes for it, I think it probably just lived up to any expectation that I maybe did have.
Yeah.
Because I was saying sort of on the podcast that I just wasn't going to get it.
Yeah, same.
The hype train sort of hit me a few days before release, and I was like, look, I'm going to get it. It's one of those that you need to play so that you can form your own maybe opinion of it. I mean, some people are going to enjoy it just for the relaxing game that it is. Some people are going to hate it because it isn't as in-depth as you would want it to be. But it's an interesting game, and it's certainly divided opinion.
Yeah. I'm kind of glad I got swept up in the hype train a bit, because I was originally going to wait for reviews and like see what reviews gave it. If I'd have done that, I would have seen like the 6s and 7s and probably not bought it.
Yeah.
But since I got swept up in it and I did buy it, I'm like really enjoying it way more than I thought I would.
Yeah.
It's like, I'm glad I did this. But sometimes it works out pretty good, I think.
How many hours would you say you've put into it so far?
To me?
Anyone. Open question. It's open to the floor. Just go.
Who's going to go first?
You go first.
Yeah, you go first.
I reckon I've probably put about 8 hours or so into it so far, so not much. I wanted to give it a good grind, but I think, like you say, it's one of those kind of casual, relaxing games. So I think it's quite hard to do a big, like, hardcore playthrough of it.
I think you're right,
definitely.
I've only been playing the odd couple of hours every now and then.
I don't know about you, but, you know, after the, you know, initial sort of wow factor of the randomly generated planets and all that sort of stuff,
it's very
impressive. I then sort of thought, okay, well, I've seen this now. Now I want to go do what I have to do and crack on down the middle of the galaxy or whatever.
Yeah.
I'm not really exploring planets that much anymore. No, I'm kind of just landing on planets, getting what I need to do, getting what I need resource-wise, and then just moving on.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing as well.
I'm kind of exploring a bit more. I found like a crap ton of gold, and with like a trading station nearby, so I could get mining gold, going to trading station, selling it, mining more gold, just doing that back and forth.
Jesus, you are putting the hours in.
I know.
How many hours have you done?
I love that kind of stuff. It's probably just like 15 hours, I guess.
15 hours?
Yeah. I'm trying to find all the like animals on the planet. It can get pretty annoying sometimes when trying to find the last bloody one. And it's like, ugh, where are you, you bastard? look up the sky, looking down the caves.
Yeah,
that can get pretty annoying, but I like the grind. It's relaxing.
I'm glad that you're liking it. What I like here is we've got, I think mine and Mule's opinion is fairly similar.
Mm.
You're really enjoying it, and there are other people who are really enjoying it as well. So I do think it's divided opinion. This is why reviews are a nothing sort of, because again, it's just a person's opinion. So,
yeah, exactly.
And it was always going to divide opinion. Sam, you mentioned earlier on Elite Dangerous, and you mentioned it again sort of when you referenced No Man's Sky. Tell us about Elite Dangerous and what you think, or how you think it has inspired No Man's Sky.
Well, I'm not sure if it's inspired it as such, but I mean, No Man's Sky has got, obviously you fly a ship in No Man's Sky, and it just seems like the execution of how you fly your ship, I don't think that's been done very well. I mean, I think that this might sound a bit weird, but I'm a little annoyed that you can't crash your ship. I mean, I know that sounds weird, but the reason I say that is because you can't really do any daring moves or anything like that when you're flying around the planet looking for buildings and things like that. There's no, you know, you can't pull off any stunts or anything like that because you physically can't kind of crash into the planet. So you don't feel like you're skilled at flying. You're just basically going from A to B. And I've been playing Elite Dangerous before, which I'm not sure if you've heard of Elite Dangerous.
Yeah.
Elite Dangerous is basically a space flight sim, kind of similar to old games, kind of like TIE Fighter, Wing Commander, things like that. And it's very, I think it's quite similar to No Man's Sky in the way that you're kind of flying around discovering planets. It is procedurally generated like No Man's Sky is. You can't kind of do the exploration on the planet surface kind of thing. You can't discover animals and, you know, that sort of thing is something that No Man's Sky does that you can't do in Elite Dangerous. But everything else with regards to exploring a galaxy and kind of kitting out your spaceship and doing cool stunts in your ship is done a lot better, and I find it a lot more satisfying and enjoying. I find it a lot more satisfying than No Man's Sky in that respect.
Okay,
if that makes sense.
It does make sense. Yeah. What do you think's next for No Man's Sky? Because I mean, I know they're going to keep patching the game. Do you think they're going to add more stuff in? I mean, I know they said that they could have paid DLC, but with it being procedurally generated, what can it add?
Apparently they are adding base building, I heard.
Really?
Yeah, I heard that as well, that they are adding that.
Okay.
And also, there's an R3 earlier today that they've got an update ready to go, which people are going to be very happy about, quote-unquote.
Is this going to be PC plus? Sam, are you playing on PS4?
I'm playing on PS4, yeah.
Okay, because apparently the PC version isn't very good.
Yeah.
Not doesn't work very well. Not very good, because it's the same game, but just doesn't work very well.
Yeah, apparently these frame rates all over the place.
Okay. Yeah, I've heard it's suffering from the same kind of issues that Arkham Knight was suffering from, where it's just a very bad port. Yeah.
Not as bad as Arkham Knight, because you can't even get that. Yeah, you can't even get it now. It's just not, doesn't exist.
Yeah, true.
Oh, imagine how pissed you'd be if you bought, like, you were so excited for Arkham Knight.
Yeah.
Like, we were excited for Arkham Knight on PS4, and we were like, yeah, this is going to be amazing. And I think we both enjoyed it, didn't we?
I definitely enjoyed Arkham Knight. I played the hell out of it.
Yeah, I played it to death.
Still waiting on that complete edition, whoever you are, who makes the game, Rocksteady.
Yeah, I think that's coming. I do think sure there's a Game of the Year edition coming, even though it probably wasn't anybody's Game of the Year, but I think there's... I mean, there's a shitload of content for that game.
Oh, yeah.
So
I was looking through that PSN because it was selling at the minute. I almost bought it on the season pass, but decided against it.
You should get it. It's excellent. Like, technically, it's an excellent game. Not on PC. Don't get it on PC ever. Yeah. But you can't anyway.
Well, yeah.
Imagine if you were so excited for Arkham Knight and No Man's Sky on PC just to get a shitty port of it.
It's a shame.
Like, make these games work.
But the bit. You know, at least one good thing about getting something on PC, if you get it off Steam, is that you can get a refund for it if it doesn't work. Or I think even if you don't like it, as long as you've only put, I think it's less than 4 hours into a game, you can just request a refund and they send it to you. That's at least you've got that to fall back on if you do get it.
That is good. I mean, the PlayStation are very stingy as far as sort of refunds go. I bought Assassin's Creed Chronicles off the PlayStation store just for something to do, to be honest. And it is broken. It does not work.
Wow.
Every time, if you die, then your game freezes and you have to restart your PlayStation.
How strange.
Really?
Yeah, it just doesn't work at all.
Bizarre.
And I asked Sony, if I could get a refund. They were like, no. I was like, right. Cheers, I'm really, really happy that I bought this digital game from you. Thanks a lot.
Yeah.
So, even though they sold you a broken game?
Yeah. Like, it's just completely broken. They were like, just restart your PS4 and try and rebuild the database. It should work then.
Like, I haven't tried that already.
It didn't. It didn't work. Yeah, like, I'm so stupid, Sony, that I didn't try this crap before I ran. Yeah, so no refund for me. Just a broken game.
Brilliant.
Yeah, so that's brilliant.
Yeah. Wait, Steam's cool.
Yeah, Steam is cool. I've got nothing against people PC gaming.
No.
It's just, I just wish that they would make things work on everything before bringing them out.
Yeah, it's easier than these days, isn't it?
That's where my issue is, I think.
Yeah.
I completely agree. I think Arkham Knight is definitely the best example of what not to do when releasing a game on PC.
Yeah,
for sure.
The worst of it is that they would have put time into making that game.
Yeah.
Button configurations, all of that sort of stuff, right? But if you've got a game coming out, and you must have tested it first.
You think so, wouldn't you?
You must have put the floppy disk inside your PC to play Arkham Knight, and it doesn't work. Oh, I don't know.
That's a PC to work, right? Floppy disks?
Yeah, that's you still use floppy disks, right?
Pretty sure, yeah. Is that the big floppy ones or the smaller? Harder ones.
Just the blue ones with the slidey silver thing.
Oh, yeah. One of those ones.
That's what you use, right?
Pretty sure, yeah.
Sam, you can confirm this, right?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, my Alienware laptop, you know, it's obviously got a floppy disk drive. I mean, why would you buy a PC without a floppy disk drive?
Well, of course. Why would you? It's just the mind would be completely blown if you didn't.
Yeah, I mean, it's 21st century, come on.
Yeah, absolutely. Sam, tell us where we can find you on YouTube.
Well, unfortunately, because I don't have 100 subscribers yet, I don't have my custom URL. Oh, so if you just type in Gaming Mule on YouTube, you'll be able to find me. If you type in Gaming Mule on Twitch, you'll be able to find me. And you'll also find me on Facebook and Twitter as well.
Sweet.
Excellent. Sam, it's been a pleasure having you on. We'll get you down here. We'll do this properly at some point. We'll have you sitting with us doing the podcast, because I think we could get a very good bit of gaming chatter out of you.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
Fantastic. You know, I'd love that. Thanks, and thanks for having me as well.
No, you're absolutely welcome. So thanks very much. And that's Gaming Mule, everybody.
Yes.
Great. Let's have some clapping.
Thank you.
Cool.
Okay, so that was us talking to Gaming Mule.
Mm-hmm.
We'll definitely get him back. It was a pleasure to talk to him. So thank you, Gaming Mule, for coming on.
Yes, thank you.
We very much appreciate it. And we'll speak to you again very, very soon.
Yep.
Let's move on to the wrestling segment of our video game and wrestling podcast.
Wrestling.
Big weekend coming up.
Yes, big weekend.
We've got NXT TakeOver Brooklyn 2.
Yep.
And we have WWE SummerSlam.
Yep, SummerSlam.
Do you have the cards up for both?
I do.
Excellent. But before this, we had some breaking news just before this podcast.
Oh, yeah.
Started recording.
Literally
which
just.
Is different for us, because we usually get it after we've done it.
Yeah,
like,
right, finished. Oh, God damn it.
a friend of the show, Steve, still a part of the podcast, even though his voice isn't here.
Yay.
He texted me to tell me that Alberto Del Rio has been suspended for his first violation of WWE's wellness policy.
Yes. Silly man.
What do you think to this? What are your thoughts?
It's strange. It wasn't really getting used as much as you should be. He wasn't at SummerSlam on the card. I don't know if they had any plans to use him or not, but we'll never know now, I guess.
Yeah, true.
But yeah, it's weird. He deserves way better. He's a really good wrestler. I don't know.
I think this could be the beginning of the end for Del Rio in WWE.
Yeah.
I know he's not been happy with how he's being used.
Yeah.
Understandable to a degree. But now he's on SmackDown, you would think he could push for the world title. I even said last week that it'd be good to see him in the title picture.
Yeah, I mean, he's the main event in SmackDown this week.
Right, yeah. So, it's a shame. We'll be back in 30 days, hopefully. You know, we can tick on and Del Rio can get pushed. But, you know, with what you've been hearing, you know, recently, the rumblings of, you know, all this stuff with Paige and how the two of them have been separated and the social media posting and all this sort of crap. I don't know. Maybe Del Rio and WWE just are not the right match.
Yeah, seems like it. He's really good in Lucha Underground.
Yeah. I've got a lot of time for Del Rio. I really like him. But I don't know, it just doesn't seem to be going his way.
Yeah, shame.
I'm just going to get the Raw quick results up.
Okay.
Raw was better this week, but it still wasn't that good.
Yeah, I felt the 3 hours this week.
Yeah, it was tough, man. It really, really was.
It seemed like some sort of a chore.
It feels like it sometimes.
Yeah. Like you want to watch it because you want it to be good, but it's like most of the time it's just, why am I watching this?
I know. I'm going to run through the quick results, and if you want to fill in anything that I missed, like last week.
Okay, Candy.
Sami Zayn beat Sheamus.
He did. Very good. Sorry, can I just say, during the match, Michael Cole once again called the Blue Thunderbomb the Michinoku Driver. How are you, this stupid?
A useless tool.
You've got to be doing it at this point, on purpose at this point, surely.
It has to be.
just to annoy his smarts.
Idiots like us taking the mick out of him for doing it.
I think last time he confused the Michinoku Driver for the Blue Thunderbomb. This time it's the other way around. So, yeah, what are you doing?
Oh, for God's sake. WWE Tag Team Champions The New Day, Kofi Kingston and Xavier Woods.
New Day.
Beat the Dudley Boys after another Devon mistake costing the Dudley Boys a victory. This is headed for a Dudley Boys split.
Yeah, for sure.
And a Bubba Ray singles run, I think.
I think you're right, yeah. Which you should get, because he's very good at
being we're big Bubba Ray fans on this show.
Yeah, yeah.
Or Bully Ray fans. It matters not.
Yeah.
We're big Bubba Ray fans, so. Nia Jax was in another squash match.
Yep.
She beat the blue-haired Rachel Levy.
She
was trained by Funaki, apparently.
All right, neat.
Fine. I like these squash matches.
Yeah, I do too. They're cool.
I like that you hear from the local talents before.
Yeah,
like,
I do.
You know, they're here to prove a point, blah, 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 blah. When they know, obviously, they're going to get squashed.
Yeah.
Fine.
But it's cool. They did the cool finisher again. Is that like the slammy move?
Yes. Big Cass beat Kevin Owens via DQ.
I think before that, Brock Lesnar and Paul Heyman were in the ring doing what they do.
Yeah.
And interrupted by Heath Slater, of all people. Which I really like, actually. I like this whole thing he's got going on.
You a fan of that, are you?
Yeah, I like it. Okay. I like Heath.
I like this in trying to sort of get a job by any means necessary.
Yeah.
I enjoyed this week's the most.
Yeah.
Very cool. I thought it was good. I thought it had real emotion behind it, actually, I thought.
I think so, yeah.
Go on.
Heath came into the ring, thought, I'm going to beat Brock Lesnar, that'll show him. And Brock Lesnar got the microphone. He says, I don't give a shit about your kids.
Very
PG.
He
said the bad
word.
So, Brock, what are you doing? Naughty boy.
This is why Raw is showing on a delay.
Yeah, exactly.
Because people like Brock Lesnar just cannot be trusted with the microphone.
Exactly.
Nice to hear him talk.
Yeah, that's cool. He's a very scary man.
He's a terrifying man, but this is like what I touched on last week when, like, Brock does not care.
He really doesn't.
Brock doesn't give a shit. He's not there to be involved in sports entertainment.
Yeah,
he's there for a paycheck. Yeah, to do what he wants.
He's not just a character. He legitimately doesn't care.
Yeah, he's got WWE bent over backwards, so he can do whatever he wants.
Pretty much.
Like, he probably went backstage and no one said a word to him about him saying shit on TV.
Yeah, good job, Brock.
Yeah, well done, Brock. Way to sell your match at SummerSlam.
But he tried to attack Brock Lesnar. Didn't work out too well for him. Took a couple of nasty-looking suplexes. And that was it for him.
Yeah. So, obviously, Brock being on Raw was to hype the match at SummerSlam between himself and Randy Orton.
Yeah.
Big Cass beat Kevin Owens via DQ.
I like this whole Chris Jericho, Kevin Owens thing.
I do as well.
I know they've just been thrown together because they've got nothing else for him, but I like it. I like Jericho. Jericho's always been good in tag teams, I thought.
Yeah, I could do without Jerry KO, though.
Jerry KO, you don't like it?
No.
Yeah,
I do not like it. It's such a WWE thing to do.
It really is, yeah.
It's like, they need a name. They're a tag team. They need a name. They can't just be their names. They need a name.
Yeah, it's like Showmiz or...
Yeah,
whatever.
No need.
Yeah.
The Shining Stars picked up another victory, another cheap victory.
My God.
Against Titus O'Neil and Darren Young.
Why are they back together again?
Well, I knew this was going to end with Titus turning on Darren Young.
Yeah, of course.
Like when I just knew it was going to happen. It's like they're not just going to cheat to win against each other. Let there be light.
Yeah, we can see now. Yeah.
There's a bit of shade in here or something. Maybe it's just my eyes aren't adjusted to the light.
Maybe.
But I knew as soon as this was announced that this was going to happen. So what's the point?
It was done.
The Shining Stars have picked up another TV victory.
Hooray.
And another cheap TV victory. So I think this could be a thing with the Shining Stars. They don't get an entrance.
Yeah, not get no entrance.
But they are winning matches. Now, I think this is going to be a thing going forward. To where eventually they will, I don't know. I see that going somewhere either way. But I like the Shining Stars. I want them to do well.
Yeah.
WWE haven't been using them well, or as well as they could be using them.
Yeah, seriously.
But there seems to be something brewing here. I know this is obviously going to lead to Darren Young versus Titus O'Neil in the pre-show at SummerSlam, probably.
Probably.
But what I'm taking away from this, because I don't give a shit about that, is the Shining Stars picking up another win.
Yeah, sure. Like when Titus hit Darren Young with Lash of Titus, crowd did not give a shit. It's completely silent.
I felt that for the whole show. The crowd were terrible.
Yeah, I don't know. I've noticed that since they've changed, actually. I don't know if they've just changed how the audio thing works. Or,
I just think this crowd was terrible.
Yeah, it could be a crappy crowd.
Welcome to Monday Night Raw.
Yay. One crowd.
It was complete silence.
One guy in the crowd going,
yay. So the biggest pop was at the end of the show.
Yeah.
This is what I'm annoyed about. Neville beat Jinder Mahal.
Yeah, I'm annoyed about it too. I wrote it down in my notes. And it's like, I like Neville. I like Neville a lot. Jinder Mahal, they brought him back. We thought, oh good, he's going to actually get a push. Going to get a good storyline behind him. Nope. They brought him back as another jobber. Crap music.
Oh, do you not like his music?
No. It's garbage.
I quite liked his music.
You did
music.
Like it? Yeah. Alright, okay.
I didn't like that it has to have the Indians like sitar at the beginning. It's like, come on guys. We're past this now. But he looks like a genuine badass Jinder Mahal does. He's built well. He's not got a friendly face. He's got a very angry looking face. Mm. And he could be awesome. But as soon as Neville comes walking down, you think, oh.
Well, he's lost.
And he's lost. Another misstep.
Yeah, he got a tiny bit of offense in, did a big kick. Well, that's about it. So why did he come back again? Why?
Yeah. The club, Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows, who were dressed as doctors, carrying a jar of Big E's testicle.
Oh, yeah.
Around.
I find it funny. I know I shouldn't.
Yeah, I like it. I think it's very funny. I think it's very, very funny.
Yeah.
They beat Goldust and R-Truth. Of course they did.
Thank God.
Goldust and R-Truth. I fast-forwarded the match. Are they still doing the Pokemon Go skit?
Thankfully, no. They've stopped that this week. Also, before that, Jeff Rollins did a segment, which was looking for Demon Finn, which is awesome. Except during that, some absolute genius jumped the rail and went in and tried to...
Was this before that?
I think so. I wrote it before that in my notes.
Oh.
Unless you got that later in your notes.
Well, I'm just reading off the app that I use for my wrestling results.
Yeah, fair enough.
Yeah, you're right. Seth Rollins was sort of searching for the Demon King all the way through the show. And he cut a great promo. And then some dick in a hard hat.
Absolute genius.
It's like a little skinny guy.
Yeah.
Why go to wrestling just to try and start on these big men?
I don't get it.
Seth Rollins might look like an average-sized man on TV, but if any of us stood next to Seth Rollins, we would look pathetic.
Yeah, it'd be tiny.
So why do these dweebs think they can go into the ring and try and confront these guys? I've seen it from a different angle, and the security just take him down, and then Seth Rollins berates him. So that's fine, and I'm fine with that. And, he tried to tempt the Demon King out, and he succeeded.
Pretty much. Yeah, I'm surprised they brought him out in his paint and everything. It looked really awesome.
I like his body paint.
Awesome. It's great.
Great entrance.
Yeah, great entrance.
Probably the best pop of the night from the crowd as well.
Yep, got a holy shit chance just for the entrance, which is a good sign.
Uh-huh. This is a misstep for me.
You think so?
Yeah, I think they should have saved the big demon reveal for SummerSlam. I know we've seen it in NXT, but there are still people in the crowd who don't watch NXT.
Yeah, you're right.
So save the big demon reveal for
a big event.
For SummerSlam.
Yeah, I agree.
This is the first of two missteps for me on Raw this week.
But I'm looking forward to that match.
Oh, yeah, it's going to be excellent.
Probably your best match.
No doubt, it's going to be superb.
In my opinion.
What we're going to do, we're going to run down the SummerSlam card and give our predictions as we do.
Yeah, yeah.
For every pay-per-view, we'll do the same for NXT TakeOver Brooklyn 2 also. But we like to talk about Raw and SmackDown first.
Yeah, yeah.
Charlotte beat Alicia Fox. Great.
Great. Wait, is she still here? Good.
Yeah, great. And this is the second one for me that is irritating.
Okay.
Roman Reigns beat Rusev in a non-title match. Rusev defending Lana's honor after last week. Was it last week? Last week's cake incident.
Yeah.
Right. You've got this match on pay-per-view on Sunday. Don't give it away for free on TV because... my interest is gone now for this.
Yeah.
I couldn't care less. I've seen it.
Yeah.
Why give away a pay-per-view match that you are trying to build over a certain amount of weeks to finally, for them to, you know, come to loggerheads at the pay-per-view for the championship, only to give it away on the show before the pay-per-view? Stupid. Mind-blowingly stupid logic.
Yeah, I agree with you. It's bizarre. I don't know what they were thinking. I was trying to play devil's advocate and I can't even think why I do that.
This is everything that's wrong with WWE. It's mindless.
Yeah.
Because we've seen that match now.
Yeah.
So I don't need to see it again.
Do we have it this time? It's for the title. Ooh.
Yeah. Great.
Okay. Cheers.
There was a couple of other bits to come out of Raw that I'm unsure about at the minute.
Okay.
They've announced, Mick Foley announced a best of seven series between Sheamus and Cesaro starting at SummerSlam.
Interesting.
Are they rivals enough for that to really be a thing? I feel like that could have been saved for Sami Zayn versus Kevin Owens.
Yeah, that would have been the best way to do it, I think. It's like Cesaro's beaten Sheamus twice in a row. It's like, why do they need to do this? What's he got to prove?
So, I don't know. What do you think to Raw this week?
Like I said, I felt the 3 hours this week. Wasn't as good as last couple. Well, last week wasn't that good either. But
it wasn't as good as the first of the new.
Oh yeah, that's impossible.
Of the new regime.
Yeah. I can't say. I kind of feel like it's going back to its old ways a bit already.
Yes, going backwards. I think it's not. It isn't good TV. I'll just say it isn't. It isn't good TV. It's not enjoyable to watch as a wrestling fan.
No, I'm looking forward to when the Cruiserweight division comes to Raw. I think that'll be a good time for Raw, I think. I think it'll start to pick up in a bit.
As long as it is given good amount of time.
Mm.
Right, the US title scene at the minute consists of two people. No number one contender matches or anything else to do with it. It's literally Roman Reigns and Rusev. New Day and The Club are dominating the tag team division. There wasn't even any other tag team matches on Raw this week.
Yeah, you're right.
So the tag team titles, apart from that, is getting nothing. No, who's going to be fighting for the titles next?
Good question.
Well, because they don't show
anyone else.
Anything.
Yeah.
Right.
Kind of think who else is on Raw?
The world title. Who's in the world title picture? Apart from those two. Well, the universal title picture, should I say.
Yeah, it's Balor and Finn. Balor and Seth.
So who fights for the championship after that is settled?
That's a good point, yeah.
There are so many unanswered questions on Raw and so many just nothing segments on it. Like, build something substantial. Like, wrestling is about winning championships and telling stories. You can do both at the same time.
Yeah.
NXT's proved it.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm not enjoying it at the minute. I'm not enjoying Raw anyway. I don't mind SmackDown, but I haven't watched it this week. I was going to watch it this morning. Something came up and I didn't watch it for whatever reason. But run me through the SmackDown results.
Okay. So SmackDown starts off with Randy Orton signing a contract for his match at SummerSlam. And he's later interrupted back again after his didn't learn his lesson after Raw. I do like he's getting a lot of TV time though, but he essentially challenged Randy Orton to a match later that night.
Okay.
And if he won, he gets his contract, as always.
Of course.
And after that, we had Miz TV. Before Miz could get started, Ambrose interrupted. I know, yeah, me too. And after Ambrose came down, Ziggler came down. And had a really good promo, actually, between the two. So we liked it a lot. Dolph showed a lot of emotion and a lot was very good. And ended with Dolph super kicking Dean in the face.
But you don't need Miz TV to build that.
No, I was just going to say, write in my notes, why did this need to be on Miz TV? What's the point?
Why are they still peddling the chat show thing?
Actually saying that, there was a point, because during a break, which is really stupid, place to put it, Apollo Crews came down and attacked Miz. But we didn't see it, because it was during the break. Thanks.
Way to build a feud, guys.
Yeah, good job. After that, we had a 12-man tag team match. It was the Usos, American Alpha, the Hype Bros, and the Board Villains versus... The Usos, American Alpha, the Hype Bros versus the Board Villains, Ascension, and Ruzango.
Okay.
Faces versus heels, basically. Bit of a mess. Bit of a cluster. Everyone came out at the end and hit triangle, took the finishes. American Alpha got the win. Faces win. Yay.
Okay, so American Alpha are looking very strong.
Yes.
Okay. After SummerSlam, they will announce a tag team championship for SmackDown.
Mm.
And how that is determined, I'm sure we'll find out. Yeah. But at least we know it's coming.
Yeah, at least there's a tag team division on SmackDown. We know who's in it.
Yeah, and at least they're getting TV time, even if they have to be thrown together like this because, for whatever reason, time, yeah. Whatever, I don't know, who knows.
Maybe Teddy Long is back in charge.
Maybe.
After that, we had a teaser for Eva Marie coming up next.
Oh, okay.
JBL called it Eva McGree. Thanks, JBL. Naomi came down to a ring with a new entrance and new music.
New music?
Yeah, it's shit.
Right, okay.
And then it's very bizarre. You need to see it.
So what, is she a face now or is she a heel?
Yeah, she's a face now.
Okay.
She's a good guy.
Right.
But yeah, bizarre.
Is she still a May entrance. Yeah thing?
Kind of. It's remixed.
Oh.
Remixed song. Yeah, it's a super weird entrance. You need to see it. Look it up.
I'll watch it later on. Yeah. I'll, when we've recorded this podcast, I'll watch SmackDown.
It legitimately gave me a headache. You'll see why.
Skim through SmackDown.
Yeah. But it's going to be Naomi versus Eve Marie, except nope. Eve Marie's been delayed in traffic. Announced by the voiceover guy, which is very funny.
Okay.
Cool. I like that a lot. Then there was a conversation backstage between AJ Styles and Alberto Del Rio, recently suspended Alberto Del Rio.
Yep.
Setting up teaser for the main event, which we'll get to in a minute.
Okay.
Then we had the Randy Orton versus Heath Slater match. Heath Slater came out to the ring limping because Brock Lesnar. It was a squash, basically. Randy was kicking the crap out of Heath Slater, so much so that he got disqualified by kicking him shit out of him in the corner.
Wait, so Heath wins?
Yeah, exactly. Heath won, and he got German suplex, DDT on the barricade, and RKO'd for his trouble. But Heath won.
Right, fair enough.
So yeah, after that we had Eric Rowan from the Wyatts versus Dean Ambrose. Bray has his chair back. Yay. That was all my notes from this match.
What's that?
Bray has his chair back.
Oh, okay.
Actually, yeah, Rowan looked okay in this match. He looked okay.
Okay.
He's been learning.
Rowan isn't a bad talent, I don't
yeah.
think.
Yeah, he got the cool
spin
kick.
Just overshadowed by Harper.
Pretty much, yeah. But he looked good in this match, I thought. Dean won with Dirty Deeds. Of course he did.
Very wrestling-heavy show, then. It sounds like a wrestling-heavy show.
Yeah, it was good, actually. I liked it.
But that's what I quite like about that, because it's 2 hours.
Yeah.
And they can, if they can fill it with good wrestling and still tell stories at the same time, because, you know, Bray Wyatt, 100% is going to get involved in this match on Sunday.
Oh, for sure.
And it's good that because we don't know how.
Mm. Was it worth noting after the match, Bray Wyatt looked down at Roman's mask, kind of threw it back behind him, walked away with Roman left in the ring. So, wake up incoming for the Wyatts.
As long as Bray comes out of this looking strong, I don't care.
Yeah, seriously. After that, we had an actual women's match. Hooray!
Hooray!
It was Carmella and Alexa Bliss versus Natalia and the other one. Becky Lynch.
Carmella and Alexa Bliss?
Nope, sorry, I got it backwards. Carmella and the other face, who was Becky Lynch, of course, versus Natalia and Alexa Bliss.
Okay.
Don't know why they write it down. That's
that makes sense.
So yeah, pretty much everyone came out during the break, which is dumb. Becky
no
Lynch,
entrances.
Yeah, Becky Lynch came down. Guy had her entrance, so that's something, I guess. But yeah, I would rather them... I don't know, it's dumb. It's okay match. Pretty decent. Eve Marie came down and interrupted halfway through.
Okay.
The traffic calmed down, I guess, and she got there in time.
Yeah, I guess so.
But then Eva got interrupted by Naomi, who was her opponent earlier in the match. And Becky Lynch rolled up Natalia into the disarmer and won the match by submission.
Because of the distraction.
The distraction, yeah. Baron Corbin attacked Kalisto backstage again.
Great, so that's going to be on the pre-show.
Yeah. There's a long, long, long video package between hyping up Brock Lesnar versus Randy Orton, which I skipped. Yeah, they could have made that 5 minutes shorter and gave the women an entrance, I thought. Just saying.
Okay.
Then we had the main events. AJ Styles on commentary, and it was John Cena versus Alberto Del Rio.
Oh, okay. That's like an interesting main event.
Yeah, but it's good, actually. It's really good. Yeah, Alberto came across really good. He had a really good match, really good showing. Shame he got suspended. Because I thought he looked really good.
Yeah, that's it.
After the match, AJ attacked Tina with the phenomenal forearm. Cut a decent promo. He went for the style clash, which he countered into the AA. And Tina's suddenly back, a little bit in health, ready to go, like nothing happened. and then he picked AJ Styles up into the AA and threw him through the announce table. It was fine.
I'm really excited for that match.
Yeah, it'll be a good match.
So all in all, WWE TV was underwhelming this week.
Yeah.
I don't understand why the mainstream TV for WWE is so poor.
Yeah.
Especially when the, you know, the stuff on the WWE network is just so good.
Yeah, seriously.
I mean, NXT is excellent pretty much every week.
Yep.
There's always something interesting going on NXT. There's always people that you care about and stories going on that are meaningful and feuds going on that are meaningful.
Yeah, I agree.
The Cruiserweight Classic is just truly remarkable. Like, it's outstanding.
Mm-hmm.
Last week's was How to Do Wrestling Right.
Yeah, seriously.
It's sports format. So it's tournament-based. The winner gets a trophy. Everybody wants to be the winner.
Yeah.
Right.
That's it.
That is as simple as it needs to be.
Yeah.
That's as simple as it gets.
Pretty much.
I'll fight you. I want to win. I want to go on to the next round. Right? I'm sold.
Yeah.
Same. Let's do this.
Yeah.
Tell a story in the ring. Don't tell it. Don't give us a soap opera before it. Don't need it.
Yeah.
WWE mainstream TV needs to take note from these other very well-produced wrestling shows that are only 1 hour long and tell a better story than these 3 hour shows.
Yeah, seriously.
Unbelievable. Cedric Alexander versus Kota Ibushi is one of the greatest matches
I've
ever seen.
Yeah.
Easily match of the year so far.
Yeah, I think so.
It's even better than Nakamura versus Sami Zayn.
It's definitely up there for sure. Them and Tommaso and Ciampa.
Tommaso and Gargano last week. It's like, oh, it's just it's like so the Tajiri match against Grand Metalik was outstanding as well.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, amazing.
Like I get excited to watch NXT and the Cruiserweight Classic.
Mm.
Then when Raw comes around, I'm sitting here like, I can fast forward this. I'm not bothered.
Yeah, checking your phone, just like, you know, fast forward it.
Exactly. Yeah. Something needs to change. Like we had change and we were excited for it, but now it's gone backwards again.
Yeah. Change more. Damn it.
Yeah. Give us something to care about.
Yeah.
Like, I care about the Universal Championship mainly because I want to see what the belt looks like.
Yeah. And that'll be really
good. And I think the match will be excellent.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's look at the card for NXT TakeOver Brooklyn 2.
Okay.
Which is this Saturday night. And we will be streaming the card this Saturday night.
Yes.
On our YouTube channel, Sonny and Finn Play.
It's like 8 p.m.
8 p.m.?
Yep.
Okay.
That's what time I'm doing it.
So, yeah,
8
p.m.,
fine.
Okay. No questions for me, it's fine.
Okay, cool. Awesome.
So what have we got? Let's we'll run down the card and we'll give our predictions to each match.
Okay. So it won't necessarily be in this order, because as always, WWE.com never puts it in the right order for some reason. So to start off with, I've got No Way Jose versus Austin Aries.
Yep, good feud, been built up very well.
Yeah.
Austin Aries has been excellent as the heel. No Way Jose has seemingly won the crowd around, and they love him.
He looks like a happy pineapple.
I like him.
Yeah, I like him too.
I think Austin Aries will win.
You think so?
Yes.
He should win, because he's so good, and I like him. But I think Jose is going to win this one, just because.
But I won't be mad if Jose wins.
Yeah.
Because Austin Aries can't win all the time, even though I would love Austin Aries just to win all the time, because I'm a big fan. He doesn't have to win all the time.
Yeah.
I'm going with Austin Aries though this time.
Okay. I was like, Jose. No Way Jose.
Okay.
No Way Jose.
Great music too. Great dancing.
Yeah, great.
Top dancing.
After that, we've got The Revival versus Johnny Gargano versus Tommaso Ciampa.
For the NXT Tag Team Championships.
Yes, for the championships.
I would love to see my guys, Johnny Gargano and Tommaso Ciampa, win the belts.
Yeah, same.
And I think they will.
You think so?
I think WWE see what they have with these two. They've been on the social media with the glorious bombs that they've been doing
yeah.
to Bobby Roode's excellent entrance theme.
So good.
They had the outstanding match on the Cruiserweight Classic, and they've been very consistent in the tag team matches they've had on NXT. I'm going with my guys here.
Okay. Yeah, I really like them
new
too.
New tag team champions.
I really like them too. I don't think they're going to put the belt on them just yet, if at all. I think they'd be better as single guys rather than as a team. I don't know.
I disagree.
I mean, I wouldn't be opposed to seeing them as champion. I would love those guys, as you do.
Who doesn't want to see a tag team feud of Gargano and Ciampa versus TM61?
Oh, yeah, that'd be good.
For the tag team titles. It'd just be an incredible series.
That would be good. That's a good point. I'll say the Revival, just to be different. And because I think they want to make the Revival look good, I guess.
Okay.
Yeah. After that, I've got Andre Almas versus Bobby. Woo!
Okay, so... I like Andrade, CN Almas.
Mm-hmm.
He hasn't really been on NXT much. He was on that episode of NXT where Bobby Roode made his... No, Bobby Roode didn't make his debut that day, did he?
Don't think so. I think he was like backstage when he mingled.
He was, and then he came and interrupted him.
Yeah.
So this feud has really come out of nothing more than Bobby Roode wanting a match at Takeover.
Yeah.
And he's got it in the form of ACA.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a fan of both guys. ACA I'm very impressed with.
Yeah.
I think he has a lot to offer going forward. Be a good acquisition for the Cruiserweight division on Raw.
Yeah.
Don't see that happening just yet. Might be too early for him. But
yeah, maybe.
Bobby Roode's in-ring debut on TV at least. This glorious thing is going to take off. I have no doubt about it. I think Bobby Roode will win.
Yep.
Same. By shenanigans. I don't think he wins clean.
Okay.
I think he's going to play the heel. I think he's going to win dirty.
Yeah. Yeah, you're probably right. I'll say Roode as well. Because it's his debut. Of course he's going to win.
Telling you now, this glorious thing's going to be huge.
Yeah, wouldn't surprise me at all. After that, we've got Women's Champion Asuka versus Bayley for the Women's title.
Okay, so fine build-up. Bayley showing good aggression.
Mm.
I like Asuka. I don't think the crowd have taken to her as well since she won the Women's Championship.
Yeah.
I
think it's because she beat Bayley. He's like, whoever beat Bayley is going to get booed, no matter what, because people love Bayley.
And I think she's going to beat Bayley again.
Yeah, I do too.
Because from what I hear, the next round of NXT call-ups is going to be in October.
Okay.
And I think that is when Bayley will get called up.
Yeah, I think you're probably right.
I think they've saved it so she can have a rematch and a shot at Asuka. But I see Asuka as a powerhouse in NXT.
Mm, for sure.
One of the top stars. And she'll keep going. And she'll keep hold of that women's championship.
Yeah, I agree. We like Asuka as well.
Yeah. There's some good women coming up in NXT at the minute. I have faith in that division.
Yeah.
I did anyway.
Yeah, me too.
But, yeah.
Good stuff. Also, we've got debuting Ember Moon versus somebody, probably a jobber. Probably some nobody. Formerly Athena in the Indies.
Probably poor Liv Morgan, who I absolutely love.
Yeah, Liv Morgan's alright. Even if she's from Jersey.
The gangster Alexa Bliss.
Yeah. Pretty much, yeah. So yeah, who do you think is going to win that one, as if we don't know?
Ember Moon will win.
Yeah.
I'm excited to see her. She has debuted already in NXT, but not on TV. Mm-hmm. So the TV debut of Ember Moon. She looks great.
Yeah.
So I'm excited to see her. It just adds more depth to what is already a great women's division.
Mm.
People were worried that when the likes of Charlotte, Sasha, and Becky left NXT to go to the main roster, the women's division would just be left empty. And obviously, then if you take Bayley out of that, and this is why I think they've kept Bayley in NXT. So that we can establish new stars in the women's division before she makes the leap to the main roster.
Yeah, for sure.
Which is fine. And Ember Moon will be one of the stars at the forefront. Fine.
Yep.
Ember Moon will win. Obviously she'll win.
For sure.
She'll probably fight Peyton Royce or Liv Morgan or someone like that.
Someone like that, yeah. But no, a lot of hype surrounding on the internet, so I look forward to seeing what she can do.
Yeah, absolutely.
And for the main event, we have Samoa Joe versus Shinsuke Nakamura for the NXT title.
Oh man, I'm torn.
Nakamura, Shinsuke. Me too.
I am torn.
Yeah.
So
it's worth noting that Shinsuke Nakamura hasn't lost a match yet.
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 Samoa Joe is just outstanding at the minute. I'm a big Joe fan. If you guys did listen to me doing the What's Happened NXT podcast, which will make a return at some point, you'll know how much of a fan I am of Joe. He's just been a different beast since he's been in NXT.
Yeah, he's so good.
His work has been just outstanding, both on the mic and in the ring. He looks in incredible shape physically.
Yeah.
I think Nakamura will lose. I don't think they'll put the belt on him yet.
Yeah.
And this just builds Joe up more as the super heel in NXT.
Yeah, for sure.
I mean, you know, Joe is ready to make the leap to the main roster now.
Yeah, I think so. I think he was when he debuted.
Nakamura probably is as well.
Yeah, yeah.
But, you know, keep him as the champion. Keep that belt on him for as long as you possibly can.
Yeah. Somebody needs to beat Shinsuke Nakamura, and I can't think of anyone better than Samoa Joe, personally. Yeah. I agree with you. I'm going to go with Joe as well.
Nakamura will win that belt.
Oh, well, for sure. At
some next point. Time round. Next takeover, Nakamura will win the belt.
Yeah.
But I love Nakamura. I think he's excellent. I mean, it's obviously so good. Best entrance music.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Yep.
It's not his time yet.
Not yet. It's close. Not quite.
Oh, it's very close, but not yet. Keep it with Joe.
Absolutely. I agree. That's it for NXT.
Well, I'm so excited for that event.
Yeah, same here. Probably more so than SummerSlam.
Yeah, I'm more excited for it than I am for SummerSlam.
Yeah.
But I think that's only because of how disappointed in the main roster I am, or have been since the brand split. I don't know what it is. I don't know if they were just waiting to get SummerSlam out of the way, and then we'll start to see, you know, new titles on SmackDown, you know, movement on number one contenders, that sort of thing on Raw, the cruiserweights coming in, all that sort of stuff. I just think they were ill-prepared. They announced it and weren't ready. And
we're
seeing that at the minute in this build-up to SummerSlam. I don't know how much longer I can keep saying. Hopefully soon we'll start seeing this and start seeing that. But, I will say it again. Hopefully, after SummerSlam, as we, you know, Raw will build to whatever the next big pay-per-view is, and SmackDown will build towards Backlash in a few weeks' time.
Yeah.
We'll see.
So,
SummerSlam is this Sunday.
It is.
And just like Saturday, we will be live streaming our SummerSlam prediction show.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe have an earlier start time, 7:30, because the card is longer.
Be long, yeah.
And but I think the show's like, is it 4 hours again this year?
I think it's 5 hours, if you count pre-show and all that.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll be doing our SummerSlam live prediction show, of course, on our YouTube channel.
Yep.
Come join us. The comments are always great. The banter between our viewers is always excellent. I'm very excited for that this weekend.
Yeah, same here.
So SummerSlam.
SummerSlam.
Let's go through the card.
Right. So on the pre-show, if you can believe it, it's been announced that The Miz, IT champion, versus Apollo Crews will be one of the first matches kicking the show off.
The pre-show.
Yeah. Which is dumb. Dumb.
Showing exactly what SmackDown didn't want to be.
Yeah. It's they're both really good, and then it's like championship. Why is it on the pre-show?
Miz is underrated.
Yeah.
Heavily. Sure. Apollo Crews isn't getting the push that he thoroughly deserves.
Agreed.
Miz has had that belt for a while.
Yep. I don't think they're going to change on the pre-show, though, personally.
I'm going to go against that. I think they might put it on Cruz.
Okay. You think so?
Yes. Miz is featured heavily on SmackDown a lot, though.
He is. I say a lot.
I'm going to go with Cruz.
Okay. You're going to be wrong. After that, we've got a women's tag team match. We've got Carmella, Becky Lynch, and Naomi versus Natalia, Eva Marie, Smart having a tag team match, and Alexa Bliss.
Great. This really on SummerSlam?
Yep.
Okay.
But yeah, I thought it's smart hiding Eva Marie in a tag team match, but she probably won't wrestle because lol.
She'll get the pinfall.
You think so?
She'll fake injury in the match. So I'm going to predict that. She'll fake injury before the match, but she will get the winning, deciding pinfall.
Yeah, it'd be either that or she just won't tag in at any point, and then as soon as like someone does a move, she'll tag herself in and win. It's going to be cool. Yeah.
The heel team win the match.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. They're pushing Eva Marie super hard right now, so.
I have no real problem with it, but I need to see what she can do in the ring.
Yeah, yeah. That's the first time she wrestles needs to be amazing. Needs to be the best she can possibly do. Otherwise, it's going to fall flat on his ass.
Yeah, the entrance is cool and very funny. She obviously looks fantastic. Mm-hmm. Just combine it, just top it all off with a good show in the ring.
Yeah.
We'll be good.
That's all we need. After that, we've got the first of seven matches between Cesaro and Sheamus.
How do you see this series going? I think Cesaro wins at... Oh, no. I think Sheamus wins at SummerSlam.
Okay. Yeah, I think they'll be, like, tied at three each.
Of course.
Cesaro will win 7-1.
Which will probably end at the next pay-per-view?
Yeah, probably. Wins about me.
That's fine. Cesaro will win the series. Yeah. Sheamus will win at SummerSlam.
Okay.
To give false hope that he could win the series.
Okay. Yeah, to prepare, he needs a win. He's lost two in a row against Cesaro already. So, Sheamus needs to win that. I agree. So, yeah, Sheamus. After that, we have Enzo and Cass versus Jericho. Your favourite team.
Enzo and Cass haven't lost. Or at least I don't think they have.
No, that's a good point. Yeah, I don't think so.
No, I mean, they win whoever they sort of, whatever. Because they're so hyped up.
Yeah.
I don't know, they just seem, like, the fact that they don't lose matches never even gets a notice because everyone's just so excited to see them.
Yeah, yeah.
The only way I see Chris Jericho and Kevin Owens losing is if they turn on each other.
Yeah. I don't think they'll turn on each other just yet. Too I like early, this team. Yeah. I think they've got some staying power for this a little while.
I hope so. But that just shows they don't know what they're doing with Kevin Owens or Chris Jericho at this point.
Yeah, pretty much.
Especially while the Universal title stuff is going on.
Yeah.
I'm going to go for Jericho to win that one.
Yeah, same here. I really like these guys. I like the promos they do.
Very funny.
Very, very funny.
Very, very funny. I like Cass and Enzo, and they will never get old for me. I see Cass being pushed harder.
After the breakup.
I see a breakup on the horizon for the two of them.
Yeah, I think
they tested the waters last week with Enzo going out there on his own.
Yeah, I guess so. But yeah, we'll see.
So yeah, Jericho for me.
Yeah, they're gonna get it. What? It.
It.
Yeah. Right. After that, we got Rusev, US champion, versus Roman Reigns.
Roman Reigns won in that incredibly stupid match on Raw.
Yeah.
Rusev needs to keep hold of the belt, in my opinion, just to give it a bit more prestige. You can't just have it changing hands all the time.
Yeah, I agree.
This feud's got legs. I mean, it has. I mean, I don't want to see this match, let alone more matches.
Yeah.
But this feud does have legs.
I don't know. I kind of think they're just throwing Reigns in there, just giving something to do while the whole Finn Balor and Seth Rollins thing is going on. I don't know.
So you see Rusev winning as well?
I think so.
No, I think Rusev will keep hold of the belt.
Yeah. Rusev for both of us. Okay. Pretty very similar prediction so far.
Yeah.
So after that, we have the tag team champions, The New Day.
New Day.
Gallows and Anderson.
Baby!
So yeah, Adrian's going to win this one.
I think the club's going to win.
Okay.
They need to take the belts from The New Day.
Yes, I agree.
Big E's going to factor in this match at some point.
Yeah, he'll be there.
I can't help but feel he's going to cost them accidentally.
Oh, no. Not a breakup. No.
I think he might cost them accidentally, though. Not sort of come down and attack both of them. The club wins. Big E joins the club or anything like that.
No.
I think he comes down and accidentally costs them.
No.
Like, they go for that. Like, the ref's out. They're going to go for that big spear thing, but instead of spearing one of the club, maybe he spears Xavier Woods through the ropes instead by accident. I don't know. The club will win, I think.
They should win.
The right time for them to have the tag titles.
Yeah, I agree. They definitely deserve a win. They've been getting pushed quite hard recently, so
and they've been excellent as well. They've been doing such good work. I mean, they've been making the most of what they've been given.
Definitely.
And like this stuff with, like, you know, where they were pretending to be doctors this week, I thought that was very funny.
Yeah.
They're excellent in the ring, and they've got real badass music, and they just look awesome. So
yeah,
I'm all for them winning the tag team championships. I'd be delighted with that.
Same here. Same another. Same prediction for us. after that, we have I've got on here Sasha Banks versus Charlotte for the women's title. Sasha Banks going to win it.
Yeah. They're not going to take that belt off her, not yet.
No. And also Dana's banned from Ringside.
I still think Dana's going to turn up.
Yep,
but
probably.
I think she's going to cost Charlotte the championship. I think she's going to turn on her.
Okay. Interesting. They did tease that on last week.
Yeah. And this week as well.
Yeah, yeah. So yeah, that's going to win it, for sure. Yeah. And hopefully it'll be a good match as well.
I hope so, yeah.
Yeah, so after that I've got John Cena versus AJ Styles.
This one has the potential to be match of the night.
Mm, for sure.
Because I think it's quite funny as well. I think it's been sort of swept aside amongst all of the Seth Rollins stuff and the Dean Ambrose and Ziggler match. I think has the potential to be excellent. I mean, AJ Styles is superb.
Yeah, he really is.
And Cena always puts a good match on.
Yep, yep.
Whether you like him or not.
Yeah.
Cena always puts a fantastic match on. He's just a complete workhorse.
For sure. Absolutely.
Winner of this, for me, is in line for the WWE Championship.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the winner will make their feelings known on next week's SmackDown.
Yeah.
I think AJ Styles will win.
I agree. Once again, he needs to win. He got
only because I think we may start to see less of Cena.
You think so?
Yeah, only a little bit less. Not sort of gone 5 weeks, back a couple of weeks. Not like The Rock or something like that. You know?
Yeah,
not going to be gone for ages and come back. But I think AJ Styles will win, and I think then he'll enter into a feud with Dean Ambrose for the championship.
That'd be cool. I've done see that.
So I've basically just given away my prediction for that match there.
Yeah. Cool. So yeah, I agree with AJ Styles. Didn't look great last night on SmackDown. Kind of ended up the announce table and on his back. So he needs to win, I think. Although it just looks a bit shit, really.
Well, they've made Cena look... he's taken some pinfalls recently, AJ.
Yeah, he has.
And it hasn't gone unnoticed. Although I don't think they mean anything. I don't think these losses mean anything. Because the end game was to have this feud with Cena.
Mm, yeah, for sure.
So it really means nothing. Yeah. He took the pinfall against Cena at Extreme Rules.
Oh,
that the last one?
I think so. And then when the club interrupted.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And... No, in the tag match.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Because they had the tag match, didn't they?
Yeah, yeah.
It was Enzo and Cass and Cena against them.
Mm-hmm.
Which turned out to be a really pointless match.
Pretty much.
But, he took the pinfall there. Took the pinfall on this first SmackDown that was live against Dolph Ziggler in the six-pack challenge. So I think he'll win this.
Yeah, I think so. For sure.
Yeah.
So then we have Dean Ambrose versus Dolph Ziggler for the WWE.
Dean Ambrose will win it.
Yes. Agreed. I do like the promos Dolph Ziggler's been putting on recently.
Yeah, I think it's been really good. I like that he's not bleaching his hair as much. I think that's quite good as well.
Yeah.
I think Dolph Ziggler's been really good here. I don't really like him, but it's good to see him rejuvenated.
Yeah, for
given
sure.
Something good to do, because he's been handed a lot of crap recently.
Yeah, definitely.
So Dean Ambrose is going to win. Did you see the Stone Cold podcast?
I did, yes.
What do you think to it?
I liked it. I like Dean. He comes across as a genuine guy, just laid back, just doesn't really care about much. But
I think Stone Cold pushed him too hard.
Certain areas, yeah. He's trying to make him talk about things he doesn't want to talk about. It's like, someone talk about it.
Stone Cold getting pissed off about it. It's like, well, come on. Yeah. He doesn't want to talk about it. What does he want to tell you?
Yeah. There's lots of them at the end, and it's like, you need to go out there and show more of who Dean Ambrose is. And it's like, I've been trying, man. I do what they tell me to do.
Yeah.
I can't do anything else. Don't lose my job over it.
Austin still is very much in the old school
mindset
of professional wrestling.
For sure, yeah.
Wrestling.
Yeah, I even saw Dolph Ziggler mention it when he was doing one of these WWE.com interviews. I was talking to Michael Cole, and it's like, it's easy to sit down on the podcast and say, you've got to show this and that, but there's another thing to actually come out here and do it. And being told no all the time. And it's like,
that's
what you did there. So after that, we've got Brock Lesnar versus Randy Orton.
Jesus, this card is huge.
It's pretty huge, yeah.
7 o'clock start time on Sunday.
Yeah. Half six. So do you care about this match? Because I don't really anymore.
No, because I really want Randy Orton to win, and I think he will.
You should.
Because, I don't know if you saw this, but there was sort of some sort of promotion the other day, like some WWE 2K17 promotion,
yeah,
where Brock Lesnar called out Goldberg.
All right, okay.
I think Goldberg's response was, you're next.
Ooh.
Could we see... Goldberg is going to be in New York for some sort of WWE 2K17 promotion. Whether it's just to push that, I don't know. But could we see Goldberg make some kind of return at SummerSlam to cost Brock Lesnar this match against Randy Orton and then cool. lead to Goldberg versus Brock Lesnar at some point down the line?
That'd be very cool. Yeah, I'd like to see that.
That's only going to happen at WrestleMania.
Yeah,
there
for
is
sure.
no way they give that away.
Backlash.
Fucking Backlash. Or yeah. yeah,
no way. So you think Randy? You think Randy can win that one?
Yes, I do. Okay. Because the reason I think everybody thinks that Lesnar's going to win, just walk it.
Yeah, you're right.
Lesnar can't win all the time.
Yeah, you're right.
They want to make it seem like that, but you just brought Randy Orton back from injury.
Yeah. I'm going to take Brock wins this one. Just a bit different.
Oh, yeah, very different.
yeah.
Real different that Brock's going to win.
Yeah. I don't know. They like Brock. Brock's scary. He's a big
yeah,
man.
Well, that's fine. I think Randy Orton's going to win. I really would love to see Goldberg.
Yeah, I'd be glad to see Brock
cost Goldberg. Him the match.
That'd be cool, yeah. I'd be down with that.
And then they can fight down the line. Fine. Brock has to win that. Whatever. But it's cool to see Goldberg.
Yeah, definitely. So yeah, the thing we're looking forward to most in the match isn't either of them. It's Goldberg.
It's the potential of Goldberg maybe coming in.
Yeah.
Like, we don't even know if that's going to happen. It's just like, yeah, okay.
And then we have the last match, Finn Balor versus Seth Rollins for the Universal title.
This is a tough one to call.
Mm-hmm.
I see Finn Balor as the face of WWE going forward.
Potentially, yeah.
But Seth Rollins is awesome.
Seth Rollins is Seth freaking Rollins.
Do you bring Finn Balor up to the main roster to have him win all these win the matches on his first night there, come out as the Demon King, or which I don't like, by the way. I don't call it the Demon King, just call it the Demon.
Yeah, that's, yeah, same.
I don't know. I really don't know. I'm going to say Finn Balor. I think he could... If they want him to be the face of WWE going forward, sell a shitload of t-shirts, sell a shitload of Demon merch, all that.
Yeah.
Then he probably needs the championship.
Yep. I see where you're coming from. I think Seth's going to win it in this match, but I don't think it's going to be the end of it. I think this is going to be the start of some sort of feud or something, and then Finn will definitely win it down the line somewhere and then possibly be the face of the company, or at least Raw. Okay. So I want to say Seth for now, just to give Seth like just a bit, just to prove that Seth is as good as he says he is and he's still that guy. Do you see what I mean?
Okay.
Because he hasn't won the championship since coming back from injury.
He did win it.
He did?
Yep.
Oh, he did briefly. Yeah, he did, didn't he?
Lost it straight away.
Yeah, yeah. Forgot about that. But he hasn't held it for any length of time, you know what I mean? I don't know. I think, yeah.
It's an interesting one because that's the one that we can't predict. Well, we've pretty much had, apart from Brock Orton, I think our predictions are pretty much the same.
Pretty much. That and the Miz at the start.
Yeah. And you're probably right with that one. But it's a hard one to call because the build-up has been so even.
It really has, yeah.
I'm looking forward to certain aspects of SummerSlam. There are some parts of it that I don't care for and will probably skip.
yeah.
But you know, the ones that matter, so Ambrose, Orton, Finn Balor, Seth Rollins, they're the ones I'm looking forward to.
Yeah.
I hope it's a good event. I do think NXT will be better.
Yeah, for sure.
The crowd will be way more hyped for that than they will be for SummerSlam.
Yeah.
The crowd definitely. Will be amazing at TakeOver.
Yeah.
Like they always are. So I'm excited. I'm even more excited that I can get up on Sunday morning and watch it.
Oh yeah.
Instead of having to go work on Monday, because when SummerSlam has been on, I've got to avoid.
Oh, of course, yeah.
Twitter and Facebook all day.
Yeah, good point. I might watch it live, to be fair.
Really?
Yeah.
What time you got work?
On Sunday, not at all.
No, no. On you're going to watch NXT live?
Yeah, yeah.
No, I'm going to get up on Sunday morning. I'm getting too old.
Fair enough.
WrestleMania and Royal Rumble and WrestleMania are my 2 a year now.
Yeah, my sleep pattern's messed up anyway, so screw it. I'll say it.
Nah, Guys, look out for our streams on Sunday, on Saturday and Sunday over on our YouTube channel, Sonny and Finn Play.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty much the end of this week's episode.
I think so.
Okay.
Anything else?
No. Unless you've got anything you want to say?
Don't think so.
No? No. You good?
I'm good.
You're good.
Okay. Good.
thank you for listening. We are the Sonny and Finn Show. Please do go subscribe to our podcast on iTunes and SoundCloud, and you can find us on any other podcast service that you may use. Do subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can hear the podcast on there as well, and you can also see our live streams and our videos of Finn losing very badly at wrestling games that he's never played before.
Hell.
But for now,
I need to practice some more.
You do need to practice some more.
Yeah, I need to come back and destroy you. We're playing Just Bring It, so when you play that, hopefully I'll be at least decent. Decent at it by then.
Okay. We'll see how that works out for you.
Yeah.
But for now, guys, we are the Sonny and Finn Show. I'm Sonny.
I'm Finn.
And we'll speak to you next time. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
Thank you. Goodbye.